Hi everyone, in this video I'm going to quickly go through what an fstring is in Python. I just want to quickly add, Python fstrings were introduced in Python 3.6, so if you're using an older version of Python, you're going to want to update that before proceeding. The f stands for format, so we could also call these format strings. Fstrings allow us to easily add our variable directly within our strings. So how does this work? Well, first let's store two variables, let's say first and second part of our YouTube name. Now, without the use of an fstring, we will have to type YouTube channel equals first part plus to concatenate the strings, and then a quotation mark with a space quotation mark plus the second part variable. Once we print this, we will get our desired name back. However, this is not an fstring. To implement an fstring, we initialize our YouTube channel variable again equals f to tell Python that we want an fstring, and then we enter our variable names inside of curly brackets so that an fstring is formed. So as we can see here, when we print these two strings, the regular string and the fstring, the same result is achieved. One other quick thing I wish to add is all Python is looking for in the curly brackets is something to evaluate, which we will typically enter as a variable. However, we could also add in a math operator. So we could have, if I work 10 hours a week and make $20 an hour, I will have 10 times 20 within the curly brackets at the end of the week. So once we print this, we get our full statement. So in summary, the benefit of fstrings is that they allow us to enter variables directly into our strings, which is extremely useful in Python. Thank you for checking out the video. If you enjoyed, please like and subscribe to support the channel. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.